background in kickboxing and boxing. He is very comfortable striking inside the ring. He's had over 80 fights as an amateur kickboxer and boxer, so he plans to lean on that experience tonight. What I want to see Miato do is counter strike. Beat your body one in and look for nasty counter strikes. He also was able to have success with the takedown in the last fight by catching kicks and dragging Adiwan to the ground. Adiwan does his best work when he's on top, if this thing hits the ground. So if Miato can force him onto his back, work some ground and pound, he might be able to take away some of that explosive power that Adiwan is known for, Ray.
Well, Miato is very confident coming into this matchup. He said, with this being an all-Filipino clash, no bad blood here, just two guys who want to give it their all to come away with a spectacular win. And now we step up to the voice of one championship. Here is the one and only Dom Lum.
Right now, Miato Adiwan is lighting up
Miato. Miato needs to get to the floor, stop standing in right in front of Vito. He's got to start moving ahead, create some feints, and look for his opportunities. Nice jab landed by Miato.
Body shots compliments Alito Aniwa, the 30-year-old, known as Thunder Kid. He got that nickname due to his powerful strikes, and boy, has that been emblematic here in this matchup as we are just over the halfway point of the first. Combination though for Miato, he's not going away just that easy.
Oh, he's tough, Ray. He's really tough. And he's showcasing a tough chin, but that is not something you want to showcase against Lito Adiwan. You give him too many opportunities, he will turn your lights out. The thing about Miato is that he carries his hands so low when he's swinging. So if Lito can time one of those shots again, he's going to be able to land another big shot.
There's a cut. For Jeremy Miado, 12-5-8, finishes a 67% finish rate. Adiwang, an 86% finish rate, on the hunt for redemption here tonight, as the explosive wushu stylist looking to advance forward against Miado.
Miado's got the reach advantage. He's gonna have to try to use it. Stick that jab out there.
Midgey seems reluctant to use the jab in this matchup, probably because of what from Adiwang.
Yeah, it's also that jumpy punch, so he leaves that jab out there too long. Miado's coming in with that big left hook. He's just gotta be fast with it. He's gotta put it out there, and you see the timing right now of Adiwang. He's got a beat on that jab, and he can see it coming. Maybe just faking it a few times just to get some kind of reaction.
See Adiwang with some feints as he digs to the body of Miado. Overhand right, that grazes Miado. Well, for Adiwang, he's coming off with the fastest knockout of his career, 23 seconds against Adrian Matias at One Friday Fights. An inside kick for the man known as Thunder Kid in Adiwang.
Yeah, but it looked like Miado turned his knee inside and checked it, and he pointed at Adiwang. He's like, yeah, I caught that clean. And now Miado's starting to gain a little bit of confidence here with the forward pressure.
And that smacked the jaw of Miado. You know, Adiwang, as we're over the midway point of the second, seeming to enjoy himself in there. He's smiling as he looks to try to right this wrong against Miado.
He's definitely up on the scorecards right now because of that big opening 5 minutes that he had, where he was able to do a lot of damage and land a lot of clean shots. But Miado is staying in there, standing his ground, picking his shots carefully. He's doing good work when he goes to the body. That jab to the body has been successful, but he just needs to follow it up with something.
I should give credit also to referee in charge, Herb Dean, for not stopping the fight. As he led, he saw Miado. He saw that Miado was somewhat trying to position himself, and he didn't wave off the fight.
Good point. Miado ate a lot of shots, too. Miado's tough as nails, so it's good to see him get that time to work. And again, with the right hand, he's scoring heavily with that duck under right hand. Right over the top and clips Miado because his hands are being carried a little bit low, especially after he throws shots.
When you look at these two guys, Mitch, they are tailor-made for each other. You can just tell. Styles make fights, and now Miado goes to softball.
Yeah, those leg kicks have got to start bothering him. Good work from Vito to mix in. Below the chin and scoring with those shots, but that was a beautifully timed right hand by Jeremy Miado.
Left hook for Miado as he backs up Adiwang.
Both these guys have mixed up their camps. Jeremy Miado went back to the Philippines, where he was normally trained heavily in Thailand. Vito Adiwang trained in his home in the Philippines for a very long time. Now he's relocated to Bali out there with some fight club, and they really just kind of changed things around, and we're seeing how that
direction for Miado. Another kick by Adiwang near the end of the second.
That's been the difference here, is that especially in the second round, is the kicks from Adiwang versus just the hands of Miado. We saw that one coming. It was able to get out of the way. We get to see a third round of the straw rugby match. Enjoying this moment, and they're having a
keep doing everything that you're doing. Everything that you're doing. All right?
Seconds out.
Bro, you're winning this one. You're winning this one.
Looks like the corner of Adiwan agrees with me that he is winning this fight so far.
Well, you know that Adiwan is not just content with winning the decision. He wants to go out there and put together a finish and really sort of put that indelible stamp on this rematch against Miato. Good right hand to the body by Adiwan.
A little bit more aggression here in the third round as he goes through a little bit of body again. Touching up that calf with those big shots. The corner scream that the leg is hurt. You can see that Miato switches back to southpaw.
Well, it is evident, Mitch, that one has the most exciting striking product on the planet. These two guys are going at it here. The fight, aside from when Adiwan put Miato on the ground, it really hasn't gone to the ground whatsoever. Now, southpaw for Miato. Once again, body shot by Adiwan. We heard that here in our broadcast position.
Yeah, Adiwan been able to do good work below the chin, Ray. Using that right hand, touching into the body with that leg. That left leg of Jeremy Miato, the swelling that's on that calf has forced him to go to southpaw. So to Jeremy Miato's credit, good job in being able to change stances like that when he's in trouble. But now he's back to orthodox. Not too much combination landed by Miato.
Is it starting to get to the point in the fight, Mitch, where Miato has to do something big?
Yeah, Miato's definitely going to have to at least drop Adiwan. Shots, and he has the power to do that. But right now, he can't really sit on those punches the way that he wants to because his leg is so damaged.
Over and left, that shot, Adiwan. For Miato, his last 6 minutes have come by knockout in order for him to change the trajectory of this fight. He needs 7 straight by knockout. There is a cut underneath the right eye of Lito Adiwan.
Good head movement from Adiwan to evade those punches. Miato tries the low kick. He slowed down. He is all gas, no brakes. Especially in that first round, he was so dangerous.
Stadium, they are oohing and aahing by what they're seeing from these two.
This is not the time that Adiwan needs to slow down. He needs to pick things up here. Miato is so dangerous still, even with that bump wheel. From Lito to evade and then look for the big right hand as the counter.
Under 2 minutes left in the fight.
The corner of Jeremy Miato is saying that he has to go. He's got 90 seconds left to work in the third and final round. What can Jeremy Miato apply to his bag of tricks? Back to work.
Can he generate enough power to hurt Lito Adiwan?
Last minute to go. Lito looks for the spin. Jeremy saw it coming. Was able to evade.
And the fans here at the Pitney Boxing Stadium voicing their approval.
Three shots landed by Miato.
being attended to, and boy, what an effort that he gave. Even though he was dropped, it looked like he was on the verge of being stopped, Mitch.
Yeah, Ray, it was close, but Beato was able to work his way back into this fight, showing a lot of grit, a lot of determination, and a really big heart to be hit like that in the first round. You can see him jogging around with a little bit of a limp, but a very entertaining way to kick off one fight night 16.
Well, we await the judges' scorecards between Lito Adiwong and Jeremy Miato. Adiwong with his hands raised after what he has been through over the last 18 months, looking for a second straight win. And now let's see who is going to get the victory. We send it up to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Lito Adiwong!
An emotional moment for Lito Adiwong. Thunder Kid gets the win as he defeats Jeremy Miato in the rematch. And look at the display of respect as Miato goes over to Adiwong and raises his hand as to say, yes, you were the better man tonight. And the fact of, for Adiwong, his parents passed away, his mother passed away, his father passed away. He dealt with an injury over the course of 18 months, comes back a 23-second knockout, and now gets redemption on his resume, and he's up.